So take a look around. There's a lot of people still shopping. And while I think there's been a big theme about whether retail is dead, I'm one who believes that is not the case. Headline after headline, though, says this, right? Every time you pick up the newspaper and you wonder what's going to happen next. Over the last 5 years, we actually have seen customers shop more and more. And in our business, the home business has grown 21%. And a recent study shows that 75% of people actually shop at least once a week, and 26% once a day. So our customers are still shopping, and thank you for shopping. But this isn't really about me. This is about how we are going to continue to offer our customers what they're looking for, because while they're still shopping, we know they're shopping differently. Tony DiCicco, the famous head coach of the soccer team who led the U.S. women's national soccer team to victory in Chile in 2008, said, "To some, challenges are exhausting. To others, they are opportunities in waiting." And I reflect on these words and say, with this great disruption comes great opportunity. It's a challenging retail environment that you innovate and that you find new ways to serve. And I think we have an obligation to serve our customers where they are at all times. And even though the digital transformation has made it very simple to price shop across devices and check whether there was a promotion last week, there's also so many wonderful opportunities that that digital innovation has provided us. Our business, like many of yours, I'm sure here, is rooted in a couple of key retail foundation pillars. One is great product, right? It's always about great product. The other is incredible inspirational marketing, and then flawless service. But each pillar demands innovation. As I said, I'm Laura Albra. I'm the CEO of Williams-Sonoma. I've been there for 23 years. I've been CEO for about 9. I feel very honored to lead a company delivering over $5 billion in sales, with 52% of our revenue coming from e-commerce. We have over 600 stores across the world, from the United States, Canada, Mexico, Middle East, South Korea, Philippines. And I am so pleased to be here at this global conference to officially kick off a much bigger presence in Europe. We have our West Elm in the UK, as you, I think many of you know. And this week, if there's one thing I have learned, it's how many people want our brands here, which we're thrilled about. And today, I just wanted to take a few minutes and talk about our journey, innovation, tradition, digital, and traditional retailing. Just a little bit about the history. You might know this, you may not. I'll be brief. Chuck Williams started our company over 60 years ago in 1956 with the idea of bringing high-quality French products to the American market. He traveled to Paris and been quite inspired. Howard Lester bought Chuck's business and was the one behind the expansion with the Williams-Sonoma Grand Cuisine footprint. He then bought the Gap in 1980, the Pottery Barn from the Gap in 1986 for its real estate. I started the company in 1995, and a couple years into it, after starting as a senior buyer, I was pregnant with my first child, and a few of us got together and we wrote the business plan for Pottery Barn Kids, which today is a quite sizable business, and really was the first in its space to offer high quality home furnishings for children. As the kids got older, so did their needs, and we launched Pottery Barn Teen, which you may or may not know, mostly an e-commerce business, almost $300 million. These businesses, these opportunities, gave us lessons for the future and future businesses. And our company, one of the key things is our entrepreneurial spirit, and we launched West Elm. Do you all know West Elm? Most of you? Yeah. Rejuvenation, which you probably don't know, which is a wonderful opportunity for us, which is a high-end custom configured lighting company that is housed in Portland, Oregon, where we manufacture very high quality lighting, and we're expanding rapidly through e-commerce. And then Mark & Graham, which is a business of personalized accessories, leveraging our personalization capability. Whether it's kids' furniture, or cooking, or home product, our internal design team and vertical sourcing teams are really a big part of why we've continued to stay relevant. We do design over We have over 150 designers now. Numbers probably higher as of this week. And we have 95% of our product designed in-house. We are not buying off lines, which is very different from other people in the home industry that you may be hearing about who buy off lines. We have 750 associates around the world. We have our own sourcing organization. We have 15 offices across the globe, and we're in 11 countries. And because of this direct sourcing, we're so close to our vendor partners. It provides transparency in the supply chain and great trust with these people, including lower costs. We're working together always to improve speed to market and take waste out of the product development cycle. And we were just named, I don't know if you know this, probably you don't, but we were just named number 14 in the world in sustainability as a company because of the efforts we've made around cotton and FSC certified wood. So this closeness builds trust, and one of the things we've always said is that we want to leave the world a better place because we did business. And we're serious about that. You know, different from other people in the business, we're sitting in the higher end section of home, and we know that if something is too cheap, someone's probably getting hurt. And certainly we don't want to fill up, we don't want to create landfill. So that is a big part of who we are that you may not know. The other thing that's important about our company is our lifestyle marketing. Lifestyle marketing. When I came in 1995, we had 40% DTC. There was no web business. But because we were sending direct mail catalogs, we knew how to ship through our supply chain things directly to a customer. We were set up very efficiently, and we developed an incredibly comprehensive database of customers. The catalogs, as you know, are shot in homes, brimming with immersive photography and inspiration on recipes, and the customers love them. We have, you know, to this day, been focused on the highest quality photography and imagery. Our stores have always been experience centers. And for those of you, how many of you have been to one of our stores? Does it make you hungry, hopefully? When you walk into Williams-Sonoma, nothing like free food, great savory, you know, food cooking at the cooktop in Williams-Sonoma. And whether it's at Williams-Sonoma or in Potter Barn, where we do flower arranging, and in the kids' business, where we have collaborators coming in signing books, or West Elm, where we have local markets where artisans show up, we really have always had a very vibrant retail footprint. In fact, we know that we drive traffic to the malls, which is a wonderful place to be right now as people go to the malls less and less. And with more and more customers shopping online, it was a natural for us to move to, move our business online. And we're still working so hard to improve this experience and to make sure that we're personalizing the messaging online as well as improving our websites and mobile sites. So each of these channels works together. They're all very different. People say omni. We realize, because we've been at it for so long, that each provides a very distinct experience to the customer, and we, as well as make them seamless to the customer, also celebrate their differences. In terms of multi-channel shopping, we know that a multi-channel customer spends 5 times the amount that a single-channel customer spends, and almost 40% of retail sales start with an online visit. People call it marketing, we call it inspiration, and we're always focused on how we better connect with our customer. So we've been successful, however, we know, like many of you, we can't rest on our laurels, and so last year we said, what can we do differently? What's the paradigm that we need to break? And we launched 2 very successful initiatives. The first is Design Crew. So we do a large portion of our business in-home. We actually go to your home if you want to decorate your house, and we help you do that in your home. But we're doing it by brand. So it would be Potter Barn, and then we'd come out, we do West Elm, maybe we do Williams-Sonoma. We realized that we could actually serve you cross-brand and train people cross-brand, because we all know that a home is full of so many things, both antiques and new things and multiple brands. And why not have that one person who you trust do the whole thing? And so we trained this, and we've launched it, and we're doing it in-store and home and also online. The second game changer is our first non-brand acquisition. We acquired a company called Outward Inc. in San Jose, which is a 3D imaging company. It's an imaging platform. We actually create the images for both our website and also our competition. And because we can make images in higher quality and faster than anyone else, we're able to use them in a multitude of platforms. And you're going to see us do a lot of great things this year. This is very relevant for the business that we're in, because as you all know, decorating homes, it's hard, right? It's dimensional, it's expensive, it's considered. And the last thing you want to do is make a mistake. So imagine if on the website, or if you're in a store, that you could look at your house with different things on it, and not just have a designer do it for you, but have you be able to run it yourself. We're developing a customer experience that the customer can use. A lot of these things right now, no names mentioned, are so difficult to use that you have to have a designer or a techie do it for you. And so we're gonna bring that to the customers very shortly, which we're thrilled about. The other thing that's important is, you know, our pineapple is our symbol. We believe we're in the hospitality business. We wanna be generous and welcoming. And that also includes that we need to deliver your furniture in one piece. And we ship everything from chocolate, frozen croissants, to glass across the world. It's hard. I mean, getting it there at the time we promised in one piece is not easy. And actually, what's great about that is that doing something that's not easy is a competitive moat. And we have always realized this and have spent so much money on our supply chain. In 2006, I was named president, and my boss said to me, I said, I want to run another brand. He said, no, you're going to do supply chain, because that's the heart of our business. And I'm so thrilled. It's such a wonderful thing to do. It's complicated in the home business, because return rate, imagine, we sell you a $3,000 sofa, it's chipped or broken, and you return it to me? I mean, you lose so much money if you're not good at it, and we are good at it. I would say that we're probably the best on large queue, and Amazon is faster by half a day on UPS. It's what we're famous for, but we know we have to keep improving it. And so one of the things we kicked off is measuring every single part of the supply chain. So every time we do anything, we take the survey. How are we doing? How are we doing? Customers telling us we're 4.7 out of 5. That's pretty good. But that last 3/10, you know, honestly, creates a big opportunity for us. We're also innovating in supply chain how we think about inventory. So because we grew up with 2 channels, we have things in different places. It's a huge cost savings initiative for us to run one inventory. But it's also complicated because things are packaged differently. You know, sending something to stores in multi-packs is very different than sending things individually to customers. But we see this as one of the biggest game changers we have over the next 3 years. And if we're successful in this, we know it's going to be even harder to compete with us than it is today. But at the center of everything that we do, the thing that we call our secret sauce, is our culture. Our culture of innovation and our culture of performance. When I started, you know, I will tell you that there were no women that sat upstairs. I was the first that did. And honestly, I didn't really think about it at the time. By now, it's a popular conversation. and we haven't had any programs, but the truth of the matter is, directly reporting to me, 55% of my staff is female. 55. I'm not looking for it to be 100. I just like it to represent the population, which it does. And by the way, our board is 50% female. And people say, well, how did you do that? Thank you. They say, how did you do that? And I said, well, we just don't, there's no bias. There's no program. It's just that we're based on performance. And it doesn't matter what your sexual orientation is, what your skin color is, or how old you are, or what gender you are. We are gonna judge you on your performance, and you damn well better perform. So that's exciting and hard to replicate. The second piece is innovation. So you saw all those businesses mostly started from within, and it's so wonderful to see people coming up with new ideas. And so we have people, we have chefs, we have architects, we have designers, we have caring associates on the front lines, and they are all passionate about what they do. The home business is a very emotional business. You ask people, what's most important to you other than your family? What are you gonna say? Your house, right? The food you eat. It's got a lot of resonance. It's just very rich, and every day there's something to learn. And every day I wake up feeling so grateful and excited about the latest cooking technique or new design. We've been so inspired coming through Europe and seeing all the wonderful things happening here. We're passionate about what we do because it's important. And at Williams-Sonoma, our mission is to enhance people's lives at home. We help people make memories. We're there for their first baby. We're there for the holidays. We're there when they move. And we build that relationship, and they keep coming back. And I think, of all things that I just talked about, that is our secret sauce. So I'd like to just thank you for coming today. I'm going to share you a quick video, one more on the way out.
Take a seat with me, and Avery, come back on stage, please, because we've got time.